Previously, we talked about blockchain consensus mechanisms and how they're used to validate crypto transactions. The two most common are proof of work and proof of stake, and I'll describe them in more detail now. Proof of work was the first consensus mechanism. When you hear about the stereotypical image of Bitcoin miners with garages full of computers, that's what they're up to. They need all that computing power to complete this process. Yes, their end goal is to get Bitcoin, but they're also performing an essential task for the network. The process goes something like this. You record your transaction. Miners around the globe have computers racing to finish an arbitrary math puzzle. The first to solve it gets to validate the transactions that occurred since the last block. They broadcast the updated information to the network, and then they are rewarded with some Bitcoin. All that computational power uses a lot of electrical power. For instance, the Bitcoin network uses about 128 terawatt hours annually. That's about as much as Norway. So blockchain developers started looking for less carbon-intensive mechanisms for consensus, which led to alternatives, including proof of stake. The algorithm for this mechanism decides who gets to validate transactions based on how much cryptocurrency a participant has set aside for the chance to validate a block of transactions. So basically, I still want the crypto reward, but instead of using up lots of computational power, I'm locking up some of my coins. For most network participants who don't have massive amounts of a cryptocurrency, competing in a proof-of-stake consensus mechanism means contributing to a staking pool. They are pooling their staked coins in order to have a stake that's large enough to get a validation responsibility. In traditional finance, we normally think of a savings account as a very low-risk and low-yield way of growing your money. You could think of staking almost like a high-risk, high-yield alternative. Another bigger disadvantage of proof of work has been the high cost of consensus that, in turn, results in high transaction fees. Many of the alternate forms of consensus address both of those issues. Here at Stronghold, we definitely care about minimizing our environmental impact, and low fees are especially important for our mission of expanding access. So we decided to build our SHX token on the Stellar network, which uses the Stellar consensus protocol. This mechanism relies on participants to choose a list of trusted parties who vote on acceptable transactions for each block. In crypto speak, it's a federated Byzantine agreement implementation, except much easier to say. In all seriousness, decisions about consensus mechanisms have a profound importance, both in terms of minimizing environmental impact and broadening financial inclusion. With Stronghold Capital, our ecosystem fund, we're supporting innovators who are envisioning the future of how we achieve these goals.